So it's the most wonderful time of the year, and that means it's time to get your affiliate program ready for the holidays. This episode will show you how.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Yeah, a little early for some Christmas music, but that's the way we're rolling. That's the way we're going to roll these days. Everybody knows that the holiday season is the most wonderful time of the year. So you got the kids jingle belling and all that fun stuff. But we think that that's reserved for December. You know, maybe like, I don't know about you, but when is Christmas music allowed? When is the holiday music allowed? Like, isn't it like after Thanksgiving? Isn't that the time that it's allowed? I don't know. But we start hearing it. Like, they're already playing it in some places now. It's starting to like sneak in. You'll hear like, you know, Living on a Prayer, and then, you know, like, you know, something for like a Bob Seger song. And all of a sudden you'll hear like, you know, Jingle Bells. And I'm like, what? It's October. But you know what? Maybe that's a message to us, people who run affiliate programs, or you're an affiliate marketer. Now is the time to start preparing for the holidays. Like, even if you're not in a holiday niche, you know, you don't like, if you sell Christmas related stuff, of course, 95% of your revenue is going to come over the next, you know, 6 to 8 weeks. But even if you're not in a holiday niche, 4 to 6 week window, 20, 30, 40, 50% of your revenue can come. So to help you navigate this incredibly lucrative time, but it's also a challenging time, I'm putting together a series. We're probably going to go about a month with this. I've done this every year for the past few years, but I've always focused on what to do if you're an affiliate. This year, we're going to talk about running your affiliate program during the holidays. So I've got multiple podcast episodes each week, at least two, sometimes three. I've got some Facebook Lives that I'm going to be doing, some extra juicy bonus content, all dedicated to helping you rock your affiliate program over the next couple of months. If you don't have an affiliate program, don't worry. I've got you covered. On the podcast here, we're not going to have any new content other than, actually, I've got something really cool coming up. I got a couple of, like, I don't know, I got an interview with Seth Godin. This is going to blow your mind because it blew my mind. And if it blew my mind, it's definitely going to blow your mind. I was the one doing the interview and it was just like, I'm like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. So there's that. We got a few other things that we're interspersing. But if you aren't running an affiliate program, you're going to want to check out the special page. We put together a 2020 holiday guide for affiliates. It's all on one page. So we're going to have all these episodes, all the Facebook Lives, all those, like everything on this page. Tons of lessons about affiliate programs and affiliate marketing, all on one page. All on one page. So we're going to talk about running an affiliate program, but also maximizing your income as an affiliate. Plus, if you're listening to this, you run an affiliate program. Here's a bonus tip. Share the affiliate marketing content with your affiliates so they can make you even more money during the holiday season. So we're going to update this page almost daily. It'll be probably updated 5 days a week over the next month or so. So I wanted to share today a starting point, though. If you're running an affiliate program, what do you need to do right now? This episode is going live on October 20th. What do you need to do on October 20th, October 21st, 22nd, like this week, right now, to maximize your affiliate sales? The sales from your affiliates during the upcoming holiday season. What I want you to do right now is I want you to analyze your top affiliates from last holiday season. So I want you to look at who are your top affiliates, say from November 1st through December 20th last year. And if your dates are a little bit different, if you're, you know, maybe you're big for New Year's, you know, whatever, then tweak these dates. But I want you to look at who was big last year. Are there any particular products that worked well? If you've got a huge product suite, what were the top products last year? Were there specific affiliates who promoted top products? Maybe there's an affiliate that was like, whoa, this product was number 27 total, but they did $100,000 in sales. It was like, you know, they only did $104,000 in total sales and $100,000 was from this one product. Okay, well, let's analyze that. And let's look at that. Let's look at how we can replicate that success with that affiliate, with that product. You don't know until you study it. So you want to look at things like how they do over Black Friday, how they do over Cyber Monday, how they do entering the like a shipping deadline. Now the shipping deadline's probably a day or two earlier this year than it's been in the past. It's that day. In the past, it's typically been like December 21st, 20th, depending upon how, you know, what day of week Christmas falls, that guarantees shipping by, you know, by Christmas Eve in all the lower 48 states. You know, that's the shipping deadline. Of course, if you live in Hawaii, it's going to be longer, you know, but people expect that. Well, it might be like one, two, three days sooner this year because of everything going on with the Postal Service and everything just taking longer. So you need to know those things, and we'll talk about nailing down your dates here in an upcoming episode. But look at your top affiliates and look at those top products. I want to share two specific strategies with regard to this. First of all, once you've identified, okay, here were your top affiliates last, you know, we'll just say November 15th through December 15th. We'll just pick that as the range. Here are my top affiliates during that stretch last year. Now what I want to look for are, where are they this year, year to date? Now, if somebody, let's say that time last year, the holidays last year, they did $200,000. And for the year, they did $220,000. Well, this is not going to be a good example, and I'll explain why. But if somebody did $500,000 for the year and $200,000 in the holiday season, that meant that, and you go back and look at last year, year to date, so from January 1st through, we'll just say October 15th, they did $200,000 as well. And this year, they've only done $100,000 year to date, same time frame. And maybe you're in an industry that's not really down because of COVID or anything like that. So on average, on a whole, you know, most of your affiliates are pretty even or maybe up a little bit or, you know, down 5 or 10%. You got to do some judgment here. I want you to find the affiliates that are down year over year. And then I want you to reach out to your big affiliates from last year that are down year over year and say, hey, last holiday season from November 15th through December 15th, reach out to him now in October. Say you did $200,000. If you beat that by even $1 this year, I'm going to give you X. So depending upon your world, let's say that you're offering 20% commissions. I don't want to go too high and, you know, use that as an example. And you have some wiggle room. So they're going to do $200,000 in sales. You're going to pay them $40,000 in commissions. If you can honestly afford a $10,000 bonus or even a $20,000 bonus, offer it to them. Because here's how this works. They're already down 50%. For them to get to $200,000 this year, they've got to bust it. They're probably only going to do $100,000. So you're not paying, let's say you offer a $20,000 bonus. You're not paying $20,000 just for kicks and giggles. You're paying it for an extra $100,000 in sales. And so it's a pretty big deal. Secondly, odds are they're not going to hit exactly $200,000. They're going to bust it and they're going to hit 100 and they're going to hit 240. Well, you're not paying anything other than just regular commission on that extra 40. But if they fall short, you don't pay any bonus. But maybe they did 160. You just got 60,000 more than you were going to get because you challenged them with a really attractive prize. So this reward has got to be something that's like insane. You know, it can't just be, we're going to give you $1,000. Well, whoopity friggin' do. You know, no, something that's like, oh my goodness, are you kidding me? So you look specifically for those affiliates that were big last Q4. They're down this year. And then you challenge them. You challenge them to really go all out. Now they have to confirm. They have to confirm. And you say, hey, if you confirm that you're in, I'm going to offer you some tips and I'm going to give you some updates. I'm going to let you know where you stand and I'm going to keep pushing you because I want you to get this $20,000 bonus. And if you got the room, make it an even bigger bonus. I did a $100,000 bonus one time. Now, granted, it was on $500,000 in sales. I offered. I shouldn't say I gave it because we didn't give it. They didn't hit the goal. But we had an affiliate that the year before did about $500,000. And I think to year to date, they were at, I think they were like, I don't know, they were trending like they were going to do 300,000 roughly. And I said, hey, if you hit this goal, we'll give you $100,000. If you do the same as you did, if you do $1 more than you did last year, I'm going to give you $100,000. Now, this was on a digital product that had very, you know, no cost of goods. So we were already, you know, we're going to pay him 200,000 commissions. I was like, yeah, $100,000. Let's just try it. Let's just see what happens. It's a pretty attractive prize, right? And they fell just short. They hit about 460. That was an extra $160,000 in revenue. I actually gave him, I think, $20,000. Told him, good job. You almost hit it. Here's 20 grand. You know, thank you. This is a thank you. The second group, so that's the first group. The second group is I want you to look for ones that are up year over year and find a challenge for them. Now, with this group, you say, like, you're specifically looking for people who are doing great this year. You're doing amazing. So you look at their Q4 numbers, you know, their month-long numbers were for that time last year, and you say, hey, you don't even tell them what they did last year. You just say, let's say there's a specific group here. Let's just say that last year they did $500,000. We'll use that example again. They did $500,000 in sales total. And in this time frame, right, same numbers, 200,000 last year. And this year, and let's say that year to date last year, they did 200,000. They're at 200,000 again this year. Or they're at 250,000. So they're up 25%. So they're going to trend towards, what's 25%? They're going to trend towards 625. That's what they're trending towards. Then you tell them that if they finish the year, and this is going to be a large part of it, is this time period, you tell them, hey, if you finish the year, because you're trending towards 625, you finish the year at 650, you know, whatever, I mean, you know, again, $50,000 bonus, or probably say, that's not really good math. You finish the year at 700,000, I'm going to give you a $50,000 bonus, whatever the numbers are. And you just come up with something that challenges them to keep pushing. And you even tell them, like, hey, you're trending towards 625. That's what our numbers suggest you're going to finish if you don't do anything, you know, special. But if you hit this, we're going to give you a prize of, you know, or this reward, this bonus. And so, number one, take a look at who your top affiliates were. Identify them. You should have a list. I don't know, 10, 20, 30 people, whatever number it is. It could be 100. Secondly, look at what products worked best and then begin to, we didn't go deep into that, but if there are specific products that worked really well, feature them. Feature them to your affiliates. If they worked well, if this particular affiliate did 100,000 last year, then maybe you challenge them on this particular product. Like, you did $100,000 this year. If you do 200,000 this year, I'm going to give you this, you know, $20,000 bonus. But make sure you feature those products that maybe stood out during this stretch last year. Did a particular product do really well pre-Thanksgiving, but not after Thanksgiving? Did a particular product do really well once December hit? You know, something like that. Look for those trends. Third, look for those down affiliates year over year that are, you know, your top holiday affiliates and challenge them. And then fourth, challenge the ones that are up. Give them something new to shoot for. So again, check out, we'll put a link to that 2020 guide. It's going to be at mattmcwilliams.com/2020 affiliate guide. I'll put that in the show notes, mattmcwilliams.com/2020 affiliate guide. Go check that out. We're just going to be updating it almost every day. We have tons of stuff on there. And yeah, go get them. Go get them. Get ready. It's time to start getting your affiliate program ready for the holidays if you want to make this holiday season your best year ever. Best ever? Whatever. If you want to make it your best, I almost started to say your best year. And then, yeah, anyway. So I'm just going to leave this in. All right, you know what to do. Go get them this week. Check out the link, and you got this. I'll see you in the next episode.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing, and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time. Yes, the most wonderful time. Oh, the most